Our flight will be landing in Lulea very soon. Now we are flying over the clouds and we'll be landing on Lulea very soon. Oh my God, you can see the fairyland down below. The whole ground and the trees are fully covered with snow. It's really looking like a fairyland. This city of Lulea in northern Sweden is situated in the Bay of Botnia. Before our travel, we have seen the brochures and it's really a frozen wonderland in winter. This city has plenty of winter activities like ice fishing, icebreaker tours, snowshoe walking, northern light tours, Sami culture experiences and so on. Yes, my aircraft now touched the fairyland. Oh my God, everywhere it's snow, everywhere it's snow. I have never seen a frozen airport like this before. So now we are in Lulea. It's a welcome sign. We'll be collecting our luggage now and we'll be proceeding towards the bus. All are moving towards our bus now. Oh my God, what an excellent view it was outside. And so we just came out from the Lulea airport and I'm proceeding to my car. You can see all snows around. Hey guys, please move on to the bus. There's a lot more to see. Be fast, be fast. We are now crossing the Lule River and on my right hand side you can see the frozen Baltic Sea.
We are now in Lulea. This is a village in northeast of Sweden and I am just standing on the Lulea River. You can see the river is completely frozen here and we'll just walk on it and it's a really an excellent thrilling experience I am having here, and tomorrow we'll be seeing the northern lights, so probably if we have luck we can see it from here. Even the river is completely frozen, you can see people all walking around the river and we are really enjoying this beautiful sunny day in Lulea. Thank you very much.
After checking into the hotel, we put on our warm clothes and thought to explore the city on foot. First, we decided to go to the South Harbour. We are exploring the streets of Lulea on foot. Sometimes we are playing with the snow, sometimes we are entering the malls, sometimes we are entering some food stalls and so on. Now we are moving towards the harbour. First, we decided to go to the South Harbour. Cars here, you can see these tires have spikes on them so that they prevent slipping on the ice. The uniqueness of the South and North Harbour are that here on this frozen Baltic Sea, winter sports activities takes place. So the municipality of Lulea actually prepares the tracks for the winter sports. This unique feature is mentioned on this board. You can see here, it's written here. After strolling for about a couple of hours on the streets of Lulea, we thought of having some hot beverages. So we entered into a restaurant to have some hot chocolate and sandwiches.
Ice track here, hete eshe amra ekhane hot chocolate ar chicken sandwich khacchi. Obijit ar Mukulda amader rishtatei thaken.
We decided for an evening stroll on the other part of the Lulea. So we decided to move to the railway station first. You can see here the car batteries are charged with some electrical devices. This Lulea actually was originally in the old town, that is the Gammelstedt, which we'll see later. And it was moved here in 1649. Due to the post-glacial rebound that had made the bay too shallow for the ships to enter. Oh no, see these bicycles, they are completely covered by snow. The owner won't find them.
Lulea railway station.
You can see the timetable here. The train from here goes to different parts of northern Sweden. A train would be coming now from Kiruna. Yes, now the train arrives majestically. It's a two compartment train and passengers will be getting down here in Lulea. We move to the bus station. We can see the police station behind. And there's the Indian restaurant before. You can still see the Christmas decoration still exists. There's a bright full moon on the sky. It's a unique sight here in Lulea.
We are having breakfast. We are having breakfast in the Lulea Savoy Hotel. It is an excellent hotel arranged by Hermes Voyages. And you can see the quality of the food. It is excellent, I can tell you it is excellent. The fruits are delicious. So I once again thank Hermes Voyages for arranging this excellent trip and keeping us in a hotel which I liked very much. Especially the breakfast was
after having a delicious breakfast, we'll be moving to the Gammelstedt church town of Lulea. It will be a 10 kilometer journey, so probably it will take about 15 to 20 minutes. And you can see the outside view, it is brilliant. It's just like a fairyland, snows everywhere. Now we have reached Gammelstedt. Our bus will move along this narrow street. You can see the church cottages on both sides.
So this is the
this is great breaking news that Mr. Obhijitash will give us one cottage each.
Patient.
50 doctor, one patient.
I must say that this is the first time I drive with a big bus in this small street, so it's also for me very new.
Okay, really?
So these houses are made of wood, and how old are they?
These are very old houses. Some date from the 1400s, 1500s. So they're very, very old. I will tell a bit. We will walk our way up to the church, and then I will tell you everything you need and want to know about.
As soon as we got down from the bus, we felt the biting cold. The guide told us it was about minus 18 degrees centigrade today. Gammelstedt is the old town of Lulea, and it is situated 10 kilometers upstream the Lulea River. It is now declared as the UNESCO World Heritage Site. Actually, this Gammelstedt is the most well-maintained church village of Scandinavia. The main attraction here is the 15th century Nedrulia church, and it is surrounded by the 520 wooden houses. These houses again are divided into 404 church cottages and also 116 buildings. I'm enjoying the knee-deep snow here, you can see. I was really getting buried in this huge piled up snow here.
And look at the houses.
We are moving towards the church now.
All houses are different.
The unique feature is that these church cottages remains empty throughout the year, except on Sundays and on days of religious festival. These cottages are juxtaposed with large and more conventional houses for the officials and the merchants who lived permanently in this settlement. Now, these church cottages actually accommodate the worshippers from the surrounding areas, and they stay here because they cannot return on the same day back to their home. The other notable buildings here are the Church of Bethel, the parish house, the Tithe barn, the mayor's residence, the captain's residence, and the guest house. You can see here the church wall is built of stone here, and it is the one of the highest building in this surrounding. One unique feature of this church here is that this bell tower you can see here, this bell tower is actually separated from the church. It is about 3 to 4 meters away, because it is said that in the winter months, if the bells ring, the vibration may cause injury to the church. Hence, this bell tower was separately built. Thank you. Tonight is the most important day of our tour because we would be experiencing the most mysterious and the profound phenomenon of the mother nature, that is the Aurora Borealis, or you can say the Northern Lights. A thorough research is required to choose this particular evening. You need to see the weather reports, you need to see the Aurora app for the radiation. You have to choose the particular place where the radiation would be the most strong. So you need a very nice calculation to choose that particular evening and also to choose the site of the view. These northern lights are the result of disturbances in the magnetosphere caused by the solar wind. Wow, what a super duper experience we had. It was really a mesmerizing event. I think it is a must for every globetrotter.
Penguin! What? Wow! Jibon sarthok hoye gelo! Pagol! Love you God! Love you!
We returned to our hotel at midnight with an amazing and an awesome experience. We can never forget this in life.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain. When I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody say your name. Cause I can't reach out to call you, but I know I will one day, hey. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, hey, hey. But everything gon' be alright, gon' raise a glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back your. Memories bring back your. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost. And I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. Ooh, yeah. Now my heart feels like an ember and it's lighting up the dark. I'll carry these torches for ya, and you know I'll never drop. Yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday. Yeah, yeah. But everything gon' be alright. A glass and say, hey. Here's to the ones that we got. Oh, cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not. Cause the dreams bring back all the memories.